Be ethical! The Flipper Zero has the capability to read, store, and mimic various remote controls that follow recognized protocols. For those remote controls utilizing protocols not yet identified by Flipper Zero, it's possible to capture their signals in a raw format, save them, and then replay them using the red raw feature. In this video, I will cover how to interpret and replicate remote control signals, identify a remote's operating frequency, and intercept signals at frequencies that are yet to be determined. Additionally, I'll cover what is required when a Flipper Zero cannot decode a signal using its default settings, reading procedure. When set to read mode, the Flipper Zero deciphers demodulated signals from remote controls that operate on established protocols. If the protocol of a remote is unchanging, Flipper Zero can store and retransmit the signal. To capture and save a signal from a remote control, the following steps need to be executed. 1. Navigate to the main menu and select Sub-GHz. 2. Hit the read button, then press the button on your remote control that you wish to capture. 3. Upon successfully capturing the signal, hit OK, followed by Save. 4. Assign a name to the captured signal and then select Save once more. Accurate signal reading requires familiarity with the remote control specifications and adjusting the Flipper Zero accordingly. If Flipper Zero fails to decode the signal with its standard configurations, alterations to the frequency and modulation settings within the configuration menu will be necessary. Configuration menu overview. This menu allows for manual frequency adjustments, modulation switching, and keypad locking during signal scans. The configuration menu can be accessed by pressing config on the scanning screen. Frequency configuration. Here the frequencies at which Flipper Zero receives signals can be changed. By pressing left or right in the configuration menu, frequencies can be manually chosen from this list using the frequency analyzer. This tool scans for signal strengths across all frequencies listed in the configuration menu. Flipper Zero then displays the frequency where the strongest signal with an RSSI value over 90 dBm was detected. The remote's frequency can be determined by 1. Positioning the remote very close to the left side of the Flipper Zero to prevent interference from other devices. 2. Proceeding to main menu, selecting Sub-GHz and then Frequency Analyzer. 3. Holding down the button on the remote being analyzed. 4. Observing the frequency value displayed. By pressing left or right, a second screen can be accessed displaying up to 15 measured frequencies. These frequencies can be viewed by pressing the OK button. The analysis outcomes may not be exact. Flipper Zero shows values that assist in identifying the frequency band of the transmitted signal. Typically, these signals are broadcasted within the 315, 433, and 868 MHz frequency ranges. Frequency hopping feature. For capturing signals at unknown frequencies, hopping mode can be activated. In this mode, Flipper Zero cycles through frequencies, pausing when a signal exceeds 90 dBm in strength, allowing the device to capture the signal at that frequency for a second before resuming the cycle. Hopping mode can be activated by enabling hopping in the configuration menu. Remember, frequency switches can cause missed signals. Reception can be improved by setting a specific frequency as identified by the frequency analyzer. In hopping mode, modulation types can also be manually switched. Modulation configuration. In order for a Flipper Zero to successfully intercept a signal emitted by a remote control, it is essential the modulation parameters are adjusted accurately, given that the Flipper Zero does not function as a software-defined radio. Selecting the appropriate modulation is a prerequisite to scanning for the signal. Failing to do so will result in inaccurate data capture. The Flipper Zero is compatible with both amplitude and frequency modulation types. Within the configuration menu, you can navigate through the available signal modulation options by pressing the left or right buttons, allowing you to manually choose from this list. Transmitting signals. Flipper Zero can transmit stored signals that are recorded on permissible frequencies within the area to which it is being used. A stored signal is transmitted by 1. going to main menu, choosing sub-gigahertz, and then saved. 2. Selecting the desired signal and pressing emulate. 3. Hitting send to transmit the saved signal. Keep in mind that some frequencies are restricted for transmission in certain regions. Flipper Zero is capable of receiving signals across all operational bands, but can only transmit at legally permitted frequencies. For additional details on regional frequency transmission regulations, refer to this video. Or if you're already familiar with all that, why not check out one of my other videos? Or not. Just remember, be ethical!